are at Crossricks Creek today, and the reason why we're here is because there is an old Revolutionary War era shipwreck in the channel. And actually there might be a series of shipwrecks, and we've timed today to hit low tide, so that way we can fly and try to find one of these old ship sites. We have archaeologists here, and we also have Jim Nichols from the Urban Coast Institute, who is, they're both very familiar with the site because they've actually advised a student on a master's thesis on this site alone. And so they're out in the water currently looking for what they had already previously surveyed from above the water. They had used some technology that sees through the water and sees the bottom of the channel.
We're not sure where the shipwreck is yet. So once we find that, I think I'm going to focus more in on that area so I can get more images of it.
You're just talking about how remarkable it is, how much the technology has advanced over the past couple of years, and that it's actually a fantastic tool for taking high resolution images. So it's great for research of all kinds.
Well, the end goal is if we can see parts of the wreckage, even if they're slightly submerged, we'll be able to process the imagery in such a way that it creates a 3D model, and so we can make measurements. And the idea being that we can then take those measurements of, say, like some piece or structure of the ship, and then compare it to historical records from the time of the Revolutionary War to make some conclusions about the origins of the ships out here.